knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave explains.
Natural killer cells, abbreviated as NK, are one of the innate immune cell types that show spontaneous cytolytic activity against physiologically stressed cells, such as tumor cells and virus-infected cells. These cells express several activating and inhibitory receptors that recognize the modified expression of proteins on target cells. NK cells make up 5 to 15% of human peripheral blood cells. NK cells represent the prototypical member of the innate lymphoid cells family, or ILC. Together with ILC1s, NK cells are considered to be a subset of group 1 ILCs, which are characterized by their typical capacity to produce interferon gamma and their dependency on transcription factor TBET for functioning. NK cells and ILC1s are developmentally distinct, but they share so many common features that they are sometimes difficult to distinguish, particularly under conditions of infection and inflammation. NK cells have been classified as components of the innate immune system. However, they have also been shown to possess numerous developmental and functional overlaps with cells of the adaptive immune system, including T and B cells. Similar to T and B cells, NK cells also develop from what are known as common lymphoid progenitor cells, or CLP. The bone marrow is the primary site of NK cell development, but they also develop in the liver and thymus. The development of NK cells progresses through various stages of maturation, expansion, and acquisition of specific receptors. NK cells derived from the CLP differentiate into a pre-NKP population, identified by the presence of CD117 and absence of CD122 expression. After becoming an NKP, the cells start expressing the NK cell markers NK1.1 and NKP46. These are considered to be immature NK cells at this stage. With further maturation, they acquire CD49B and CD11B expressions and lose CD27 expression. Fully mature NK cells are able to express cytolytic molecules and cytokines, including interferon gamma. Human NK cells are thought to be fully mature when they have high cytolytic activity and are able to produce large amounts of interferon gamma. The total population of human CD3-, CD56+, NKP46+, NK cells is phenotypically and functionally diverse. Approximately 10% of NK cells found in blood have high surface density expression of CD56 and can produce abundant amounts of cytokines and chemokines within minutes of activation. Yet these CD3-, CD56 bright, NKP46 bright cells, bright referring to their high density surface expression of these receptors, cannot spontaneously kill tumor cell targets. In contrast, the majority of circulating human NK cells with low surface density or DIM expression of CD56 and NKP46 have a relatively lower ability to produce cytokines in response to activation, while some but not all can spontaneously lyse susceptible tumor cell targets. CD56 bright and CD56 dim NK cells may have relatively distinct and important roles during the human immune response. NK cell stimulation and effector function is dependent on signals derived from two distinct types of cellular receptors, activating and inhibitory receptors. The interaction of NK cell inhibitory receptors, natural killer group 2, member A, or NKG2A, and LY49A with its cognate ligand leads to phosphorylation of immunoreceptor tyrosine-based inhibitory motif ITIM in their cytoplasmic tails. Phosphorylated ITIM then recruits phosphatases that dephosphorylate signaling molecules, thereby terminating activating receptor signaling in NK cells. Interaction of activating receptor NKG2D and LY49D with their cognate ligand leads to phosphorylation of YINM motif, or immunoreceptor tyrosine-based activation motifs called ITAMs, present in the cytoplasmic tails. The net result of this signaling pathway is the release of cytokines and chemokines, as well as cytotoxic molecules by the NK cells. Normal healthy cells always express MHC class 1 molecules on their surface that act as ligands for inhibitory receptors and contribute to the self-tolerance of NK cells. However, virus-infected cells or tumor cells lose surface MHC class 1 expression, leading to lower inhibitory signals in NK cells. In addition, cellular stress associated with viral infection or tumor development causes senescence program or tumor suppressor genes to upregulate ligands for activating receptors in these cells. As a result, the signal from activating receptors in NK cells shifts the balance toward NK cell activation and elimination of target cells directly through NK cell-mediated cytotoxicity, or indirectly through secretion of pro-inflammatory cytokines. The NK cell cytotoxic response is divided into several steps. First is the formation of immunological synapse between the target cell and the NK cell that leads to the reorganization of cellular actin cytoskeleton. Polarization of the microtubule organizing center, MTOC, and secretory lysosome toward lytic synapse occurs in the next step. Then, secretory lysosome docks at the plasma membrane of NK cells. And finally, the fusion of secretory lysosome with the plasma membrane of target cells occurs. The final act of the entire process is the release of cytotoxic molecules such as perforin and granzyme in a process known as degranulation. Another process by which NK cells mediate the killing of target cells involves death receptor-induced target cell apoptosis. Engagement of the death receptor with its cognate ligand induces a conformational change in the receptor and recruitment of adaptor proteins, leading to apoptosis of target cells. NK cells express FASL, TNF, and TRAIL receptors that bind to their respective ligands on the target cells. Furthermore, activated NK cells secrete a wide variety of cytokines, such as interferon gamma, TNF-alpha, GM-CSF, IL-10, IL-5, and IL-13, as well as chemokines such as MIP-1-alpha, MIP-1-beta, IL-8, and RANTES. Interestingly, unlike other innate cells, NK cells are able to acquire functional qualities associated with immunological memory in both non-infection settings and in response to pathogens. NK cell memory can occur in two ways, either via an antigen-dependent virus or haptin-induced mechanism, or an antigen-independent cytokine-induced mechanism. For example, in a viral infection setting, NK cells are able to respond specifically to it, and in many cases are able to develop memory recall responses. With regards to cancer, NK cell function was discovered initially for their ability to kill tumor cells without prior sensitization. They are able to directly kill tumor cells through the release of cytotoxic granules containing granzyme and perforin. The involvement and importance of NK cells has been recognized in various disease conditions. Classical NK cell deficiency, CNKD, is characterized by the absence of NK cells and their function among peripheral blood lymphocytes. Patients suffering from this disorder typically die due to causes such as cancer or infections. Functional NK cell deficiency, FNKD, describes individuals who have normal numbers of NK cells present in peripheral blood, but they are functionally challenged and therefore affect normal immune responses. Quantitative and qualitative NK cell variations have also been implicated in human autoimmune diseases, thus underlying the importance of these unique innate immune cells. And with natural killer cells covered, let's move forward and examine one more type of innate immune cell.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.